CreativeGuitarStudio.com. One of the most sought after skills that a musician works toward is being able to have a really good ear, you know, because once you have this ability, it allows you to be able to listen to a piece of music and learn the notes, learn the rhythms, learn all the chords that fit with the music of any song. But the problem that, you know, happens is even though a lot of people learn to play guitar fairly well, they end up having problems when it comes to listening to a piece of music and then understanding what the notes are, what the key is, and how to transpose the piece, how to write the piece down, all that stuff. So the subject category of this particular topic is referred to as ear training. And since it's one of the most important topics that music students study, we're going to discuss it here in this episode of the Guitar Blog Insider. You know, sometimes guitar players, musicians tend to neglect to do certain types of musical training because the study of it itself seems far too simplistic, and ear training is certainly an area that falls into this type of category. So the initial work, you know, it seems so simplistic that musicians often blow it off and don't even bother studying it at all. Now, in order to be able to learn how to recognize notes and chords and rhythm, you're going to have to start at the very basics. And this means doing analysis and transcription of the most simple melody lines and harmony parts. These types of lines are most common to and most popular in the works of the music of children's melodies. Now, this means that children's melodies are some of the best songs for the initial study of ear training. So I'm going to play you a common children's melody right now. And I'd like you to stop this recording as much as you feel that you need to in order to learn this melody by ear. Don't rush over to the blog post page and look at all the music that I've got there for you. Instead, I want you to just learn this melody by listening to it. It isn't a very hard one to learn. Let's do this. Okay, so once you've developed the ability to hear the most simple melodic lines of something like a children's melody, like the one I just performed, it's time to also start learning what chords would fit along with the melody line. This is where the use of the 1-4-5 harmony concept in chord progressions can come in really handy. You see, the use of the 1-4-5 chord harmony to apply a backing track progression can work over any melodic line. That's right, it can work over any melodic line. So let's do this and hear what that might sound like if I go ahead and play a 1-4-5 series of chords over the melody that you just heard. Now that you've spent some time trying to learn a melody and you've had some experience with a backing chord progression that's associated to the melodic phrases, let's try all this again using another simple children's melody. Once again, I'll start by performing the melody line for you so that you can try and learn it only by ear. Remember to stop the video as much as you need to when you're transcribing the melody. Let's do it. Hey, I know that we're only halfway through this video, but I wanted to stop for just a moment to let you know about the guitar courses over on my website at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced courses that work alongside of in-depth guitar elective programs to form the best guitar courses available. The courses work to help you learn to identify what's required to get you up to that next level of guitar playing, and they do it in a very organized, step-by-step way that just simply makes sense. So I look forward to helping you further at my website, creativeguitarstudio.com. Let's get back to the lesson now on how to improve your listening skills. Now, learning a melody along with a set of backing chords is obviously really good work. It's incredibly valuable, but you unfortunately can't stop there. There's more work to do with this whole ear training thing. You're going to need to take your ear training studies a few steps further in order to be able to really build your ear training skills up to much higher levels. Two further steps I'd like you to take beyond learning the single note melody lines and the backing chord changes that we just went over. We'll be going further and learning how to accurately write out the rhythm and learning how to properly notate the piece in traditional music notation, not tab. You can start with tab, but I would really suggest progressing over to getting this going in traditional music notation. Plus, along with that work, I also want to add to this that learning how to transpose any song over to another key is integral, because being able to do all of these additional tasks is going to lift you from being a guitar player up to actually being a musician, so that you know and understand music even when your guitar is tucked away in the case. Now, what I'm going to do next is take that last piece that I had just played for you, and I'll play it in another key. I'd like for you to listen to the new rendition and learn the new key signature that it was transposed over to. So let's get to work. Now, you're probably going to want to invest some solid study time on learning all these ear training skills, which will mean making a study of the pieces that I've performed in this lesson. So I've got all these melodies and chords laid out in notation for you. Just head over to my blogger site at creativeguitarstudio.blogspot.com. Well, you know, learning ear training skills can be a pretty tough study as far as music skills go. Ear training ability can take a long time to grow on you as a musician, and there will be hours in in-depth study that will involve several years to fully develop before you really feel like you have a complete handle on being able to just simply listen and then learn a song all by ear. And that includes learning the chords that fit into a piece of music and be able to properly chart the rhythm and musical notation and transpose it to other keys, all that stuff. You know, to be able to have that ability one day to write out a music chart in chart copy form, you know, it's a lot of work. The good news is that really any dedicated musician can learn how to do this, but it does require a lot of persistence, a lot of long hours in order to really gain the technical skill for being able to learn and then copy out recorded music strictly by ear and by ear alone. Well, as always, thanks for joining me. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Be sure to remember to hit that bell so that you never miss any of my uploads to YouTube. Until next time, take care, and we'll catch up again on the next video. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.